will not be surprised at all if he does go for it. Beastmaster can be played in that four position role very effectively in the jungle. Can get the level 6 by about 5-6 minutes in as well. Of course, Crate potentially rotating in could be a potential factor. Lucarian, Terrorblade isn't auto-banned. Terrorblade gets banned out sometimes, but it's generally against players like Fear. Other than that, it's not really banned out all that often. That being said, though, the Terrorblade, not the greatest pick, not the greatest pick over here. So he goes for a Medusa instead. Arteezy goes full in on the Lightsphere counter. He's really hoping that this works out. The Stone Gaze has some synergy with the Phoenix Egg as well, forcing people to run away from the egg and doesn't really allow them to try and go up to it and hit it. So definitely the synergy is there, but the question is, can they get the farm up onto this Medusa, and what are they going to be going as their supporting duo, of course, because really when you have a Medusa on your team, practically everyone else is acting as a support for that Medusa. Everything has to be perfect for that Medusa, and Disruptor is the one that's being picked up right now. So he does, PPT does reveal it to be an offlane Beastmaster, still not revealing his final pick, still not revealing his middle lane hero, which will be coming in the last pick. So RTS, he needs to be very smart about this. He needs to leave the possibility of it being a middle lane Medusa in here. So probably will be picking up the offlane right now. Then again, could also be a carry Medusa. You never really know with RTZ. He could be going for either one. He could be playing either one. And Matumba, man, it will be the Slotha block pick coming through. Looks like he wants to be banning out something like the Nyx Assassin. Nyx Assassin in the mid lane, obviously going to be a big issue, a big problem for the Dire side to be able to deal with. That does mean that that would leave them quite open to being potentially being outpositioned very easily, simply by virtue of them having four melee heroes. Awesome, Deadman. I think if I slow down, I'm going to fall asleep, to be completely honest. It's 5 a.m. over here. I've been casting for the past 5 hours. I feel like I'm going to pass out too. I'm just casting this game because it's so stacked. I have to cast this. I'm just so excited to be able to cast a game with all these tier 1 players, because obviously, for me to personally be able to cast a tier 1 Dota game, it's a dream that's very far off. Obviously, the dream is there, but you know, the dream isn't quite real yet. But right now, the question is, PPD's fifth ban, what is he going to be going for? He needs to take out a mid hero, most likely. But first of all, he needs to make the decision. Is this Medusa going to be going in towards the mid lane, or is this Medusa going to be going over towards the safe lane carry position? That's more of the traditional old school Medusa style, not really what we saw in the Southeast Asian qualifiers. Mushi was the one who played that up quite a bit. I'm from Pakistan, Lucarian Storm. I'm casting this game from Pakistan. It's very late over here where I am. You can actually, I can show you guys Dawn. I think you can see that. Kind of, yeah, that's sunlight outside. So, yeah. Definitely very excited about this game. Staying up very late to be able to cast this up. That's why my voice sounds slightly dead, because I've been casting for so long, and I've been casting every day for about 5 to 6 hours. And immediately, the Broodmother ban coming out at the very last second. PPD not wanting to be played up by a Bulba Broodmother in that mid lane that we do, but that we have seen once before yesterday. Bulba did pick that up for himself, and whew, I've just got to say, I have no idea who's posting links. 5 seconds. We need more KPM. I'm fairly sure Reddit links are allowed. If you don't do that, I think they're allowed. So, you know, welcome to the stream. Thank you for coming in from Reddit. We need more KPM, and you are right. We do indeed need more campus per minute. But right now, what we need is this game to start, and I just want this draft to be over with. The Templar Assassin ban coming out. It's a good range hero that's going to be able to deal with Medusa in the lane quite a little bit if PPD did want to be going for that. Yeah, we're also very, very strong on that TA, and combining that with the single damage burst down potential that you have with the Beastmaster blink and initiate with the roar, that's just insane amounts of damage coming up from a Templar Assassin. If you're able to get the blink in melt strike, that's ridiculously good. That being said, the Drow Ranger is the pickup for RTZ, so it's going to be a middle lane Medusa and a Tinker pick coming out for Yaur. This game could go. Oh my god, it's a miracle Tinker. Yeah, I might be overreacting a little bit. I might be overreacting just a little bit. Thank you very much, Drog5. I worked on my accent quite a bit. Thank you for the follows, everyone, by the way. So Miracle Tinker, man, this game is gonna be an absolute legendary. Hello, Roy. Rory is a fan. Welcome from Reddit. Everyone from Reddit, welcome to the stream. Thank you all very much for tuning in. I did just make the post over there, so should be a bit interesting. So Drow and Medusa together. The greed is off the charts, but this could work out. But the X factor is going to be, as always, Miracle on his Tinker. Can he outperform? This is 9,000 MMR versus 9,000 MMR, the only two players in the world to have broken that 9K MMR point are facing off against each other in a matchup that we never thought that we would be able to see for so long. Somel has taken a side and he's playing up a support. Once again, PPD on the Disruptor, Somel on the Bounty Hunter. The 9,000 MMR off the comparatively east. He's from, well, he's not really east, but he's kind of from the middle. But let's call him from the east versus the 9,000 MMR player from the west. This is one hell of a storyline. Yower, the two brothers on the Radiant side, playing up on the Lifesteal, Beastmaster being piloted up by none other than Moon Neander, the Canadian of this team. Then the Canadian of the opposite team is, of course, a 9K MMR player. And just as I say that, I miss First Blood. I'm way too hyped about these things. But just as I say that, we do have the Dark side, 9,000 MMR, the carry of the West, RTZ. There's been many doubts about him, but those doubts are about to be put to the question. Can he play this game out? Can he win this game? Can he defeat the greatest opposition that he's ever faced? The greatest MMR challenge that he's ever had? The biggest hurdle all time, RTZ, has to face that up right now. It's going to be some male scouting that out. There's a sentry ward over here. Quid going in from the back lines and immediate dust going out as well. So Mel going to be slowed up. The second he got that bounty rune, he immediately crit. Going in with the boulder roll, helping them get the second blood of the game. It's a 1-for-1 overall across the board. It's interesting. Sentry wards coming out. They're actually blocking out both the camps. It's going to be a bit of a dual lane coming through. Mantumba Man on the Drow Ranger, MSS on the Phoenix. We're going to quickly finish up introductions. Crit, the legend himself on the Earth Spirit. And finally, Bulba on the Slardar mid lane matchup. We look to be seeing quite a little bit of exchange going down right now. RTZ sitting at 2 for 0 compared to Miracle and 1 for 2. Miracle definitely getting the sizable deny advantage and to some extent the experience advantage as well, but that will be negated somewhat as top lane Matumba Man being harassed out very effectively by the bounty hunter of Somel. Somel, of course, having played the core position so much that at this point it is second nature to him. Crit, though, he's going in onto his own teammates. His brother versus brother. As Crit trying to go on to Miracle, but the power of friendship prevails, and Crit perhaps missing the rolling boulder in the name of one's companionship. But there is no companionship over here. PPD ejects Bulba from the game the same way he ejected him from the Evil Geniuses lineup, and Bulba comes right back into the fray, level one only. And unfortunately, the declaration of boots has come through. My camera control is so completely out of like, my camera control is non-existent at this point, really. Mid lane, once again, Miracle taking some significant damage. Apparently, people are. Are people talking? Wait, what? Okay, Ryuburus is casting. No, Ryuburus is streaming. I had Ryu's stream open for some reason, but never mind. Miracle in this mid lane might be getting a little bit of assistance right now. RTZ getting Thunderstruck up. He doesn't have the mana shield, 2 points in it. Won't be able to save him when he doesn't have any mana whatsoever. Gems could have come through, but would have been largely ineffective. And now PPD with that haste rune wants to be harassing Bulba just a little bit more. Well, on the mid lane, Tinker does go down. I've managed to miss every single kill so far except for one. Guys, what is happening? What is happening to my camera control? I'm normally so on point with this. The years are taking their toll onto me, and right now, the years are in the favor of Yara as he does manage to stay on top of the last hit charts. All three people in the top three are belonging to the Radiant side. Beastmaster, though, of course, is last hit's being a little bit bloated by the jungle creeps that he has managed to collect for himself. So Mel making his way to the mid lane once again. The sentry ward doesn't scout him out this time. Quit keeping down, picking up Arteezy's bottle for him. And we've got to keep in mind this is the matchup that we need to keep our eyes on. This is where the game will be decided. If Miracle goes down a few more times, if his boots of travel are delayed a little while longer, that could be the end for the side of the East. I still need a word to call Miracle at this point. I can't call him the 9K of the East because he's really not East, he's technically West. I can't go my this is my house. The library in my house. But yeah, I can't turn on automatic camera. I'm casting from Islamabad. I can't turn on automatic camera because I'm in the lobby, so you don't have directed camera in the lobby. Don't worry, guys. I will step up my game now. Don't worry. I'm not going to miss a single kill so far. And just as I say that, we do see a rotation going up towards that top lane. The smoke gang coming through from three people. Well, two people and one invis person. But Matumba man, got to be careful. He could be slowed up somehow. Now the PPD coming in with the Thunderstrike. Does have the glimpse, but not quite in range of it. Just quite yet. The silence wears off. He's able to get it off with the kinetic field. Matumba man should be going down over here. Invisibility rune going the way of Arteezy. He will be activated up, but now the Phoenix heal coming through. MSS doing what he can, but in the end, Matumba man will take a fall. He lived for very long, but the kill does go the way of Beastmaster, and Moon Meander picking that up. That's going to be the exact start that he needed. Level 5 almost on him. Miracle narrowly avoiding the snake off Arteezy. Crit still hanging around in the high ground. An aggressive ward coming through from the Dire side. They do have a significant vision off the Radiant side mid lane. While bot lane, we do see Yaur perhaps going in for a dive onto Balba. Balba using the sprint, but Yaur choosing not to commit too hard onto that if the rage wore off at the same time as the Slytherin crush. And we saw TP coming in. That could have been a big kill. Now Sumail, he's the one who's been boulder smashed up. He's the one who's been sunrayed up, and one more right click from Crit is going to be all she wrote. Mid lane, the matchup looking so damn even. Arteezy level 6, Tinker level 6, both have one assist, both have the same last hit, similar denies as well. And this is a matchup of the Titans. Then the Titans aren't the ones who are going to be clashing, it's going to be the little minuscule action figures we're going to be clashing as PPD throws out a kinetic field, doing what he can. Arteezy with a Mystic Snake from the low ground. He's going to be trying to back himself off. Mana is getting low. MSS gets taken down. The laser and the rockets are going to be enough to chase him down. Sumail still in pursuit of Arteezy. Moon going in there as well, but the boards aren't in range to be able to get that kill. And Miracle getting juked out by Crit. Crit with the jukes to the side. He has purchased up his items. Will deny himself over towards that neutral strike that he has going, even scouting that out in the process. Beautifully done by Crit. 9k isn't enough to outplay the OS Frog Spirit, but Sumail now making his way to the mid lane. Arteezy is low, 280 HP, and he knows this. The raindrops are all that stand in the way of him and Miracle's complete victory over this lane. Radiant scientists confirming the location of the drow. I do have a casting schedule, eight chickens. I'll get to that in a little while. I'll respond to the chat after. I just need to make sure that I don't miss any kills. After the amount of kills that I missed in the early game, hopefully those will not be all that high. Now, Crit putting down a nice little ward will be able to be sure that they know when Miracle is going for that stack. Now Miracle, he's very low, he's gonna get rolled on, but Crit dodges it, a rare miss coming out from MSS throwing out the Sunray, but MSS is gonna be the one who's taking all the damage, and Tinker turns around with a laser on a two. Wow, that was a great kill from PPD, catching him in the middle of the Icarus Drive, but a laser onto the Earth Spirit, and that's going to be all she wrote. Yaur keeping in, Moon with a roar onto Arteezy, and suddenly Arthur, he's got no way of coming out of that gank, and suddenly in the backline somehow The Medusa snake bounces to the Tinker, and 9k MMR players all around. That was a really sick play from RTZ though, just turning around, getting that Mystic Snake up. That was really cool. I don't have the ticket, actually. I'm inside the game. I'm casting from the lobby. Oh, you guys want to watch on the ticket. Never mind, but wait, hold that thought. Haze Rune coming in. Bulba, he sprints away, but there's no way you're getting away from Yawer and his Haze Rune. No mana on him to be able to use up that raise, though. And now with the Sunray coming in, the Laser Beam is going to be enough to guarantee Bulba safe passage. Now Miracle, he's the one who's at risk as he's being right-clicked away by RTZ. RTZ getting his mana back up. Mystic Snake being used to spam out the wave as well. And Crit, just look at how slowly he right-clicks. Look at how slow he is. And Sumail trying to punish that very slowness. And Crit kicking him away, but the Shuriken Toss follows through and Sumail gets that kill. That was a really good try from Crit, unfortunately. Just not quite enough. Sumail with the support play, a little bit too strong. Definitely holding his own in this game as a support player. Sumail, who would have known, one of the greediest mids in the game, possibly. Been compared to Arteezy when he played up those middle farming roles. Very often. Grant is not going to be streaming. Thank you for the cast, though. Grant won't be streaming. I already asked him about it. Grant said he's not going to be able to stream. I do understand why you would go over to him, though. Thank you for tuning into me instead of MSS. Now, it is going to be Moon Meander, 1700 gold on him. He's close to that. Well, he's fairly close towards that Necro, but actually already has the Belt of Giant's Trend as well. Only needs a recipe, which is about 400 gold away from him, so 10 minutes in, getting some decent farm onto himself, but top of the net worth, somehow or the other, is going to be Matumba Man, who does have something on the courtier, does he? I think that's his Ogre Club, and that will be the makings of the Dragonlance coming out onto the Drow Ranger. Drow Ranger, of course, benefits so greatly from the Hurricane Pike, those additional, that additional attack speed, and from that extra range as well. Matumba Man might spot out the, oh no, the courier might be going down already. The silence could come through. Smile could be going down, but instead Matumba Man not fast enough with his fingers. If he used the silence over there, that could have been a big kill, but perhaps being a little bit fearful of Yawer potentially being infested in, even though he might have actually seen him earlier on. The top lane tier one should be going down right now. Moon Meander doing quite a bit of damage to it, but Miracle sitting far back. He's realized exactly what's up. No wards up for him, but his spider senses, they're tingling and they're telling him to stay away from that tier 1 tower. Rightfully so. RTZ now circling around from the back lines, trying to go into that stack. They will be able to get that up very easily. And that's going to be a very sad Tinker. Miracle just going to be staring at them, running at, and now they're going to be able to run him down. Bulba going, getting up close enough to get the Thuzzlebane Crush Shot. That's a big misplay coming out as well. Crit with a stun. Sumail might be able to get the trade off, but now with the dust, Sumail might be another casualty in this war of the 9Ks. Yawer, one more right click onto MSS is all he needs. No Icarus dive ready for him. Tries to use the Sunray, but that really doesn't help in the slightest. Top lane, RTZ TPing himself away. Yawer now once again in the top two. The Ogre Club was in fact Matumba Man. He has enough gold to be able to complete up that, whatchamacallit, Dragonlance. Yes, of course. Should be able to complete up that Dragonlance very well, very easily. But PPD, look at how absolutely rich he is over here. He's almost as farmed as Bulba. Matumba Man getting a nice little silence out into a TP. PPD not able to do anything about that. The gust was in fact a high, well, a 3 second gust. I think PPD could have actually silenced that, could have actually glimpsed that. Now the question is, does gust, the 3 seconds of gust, do they include the knockback time, or is the knockback time a separate thing? Because if it's 3 seconds, then including the animation time and the backswing, the Drow Ranger should not be able to TP herself away. The glimpse should be able to come through. I think glimpse is instant cast. Don't quote me on that. I'm like 90% sure it's instant cast though. Moon Meander now with the roar up and ready, trying to potentially go onto his teammate. Right now, MSS on the mid lane, who's tracked up, is the one who's going to be having some issues. Crit in the trees, scouted out, the roar goes out, the trees are cut down, the lumberjack time, and the trees aren't the only thing being cut down as Moon picks himself a killing spree. The Phoenix is the one teeping in towards that bot lane, throwing out the Sunray onto Moon, though then there's an immediate turnaround gank coming through. And four people on this bot lane mean this tier 1 tower should be seized, and Miracle immediately reacting to this, making his way towards that top lane. No boost of travel up just quite yet, but this will be a lot of split pushing being done by him in the meanwhile. Radiant decide against going for the tier 1 tower, thinking that it is perhaps not worth it. The lightsaber isn't Sumail, and he will be forced to pop out. He's going on to Matumba Man, but decides against it. Yaur wisely TPing himself away. They've got no way to cancel it. Balba, without a single point in that bash, couldn't even try and right click away for the RNG goodness. APD, he's the one who almost gets slowed up, but somehow manages to get away, trying to juke that boulder smash, but Crit, he's the one who's gonna be caught. It's a trap, says PPD, he's still right-clicking waves, fighting him up, and Beastmaster will be able to get that kill, TPing in to take away another light from his comrade. And Bulba, 1100 gold on him, he's gonna be the one going in, he gets revenge. You kick me, and I kill you, he says. And Sumail gets a track onto him, Moon. Roar at the ready, they will be able to get a track kill. This is a massive kill for them to get. This is a 3-man track kill. And that was definitely not worth it. The offlane for a support and giving away 3-man track kill to boot. The Radiant going to be more than happy with that. In the meanwhile though, Arteezy is still a true winner of this series of skirmishes so far. He's just been left to his own device. He's been free to farm up everything he wants to. 84 last hits on him, Dragon Lance as well. And right now it's going to be all up to PPG once again to get a good ultimate off of a hair. If Crit is able to get off a good magnetize, it's actually on cooldown, which is going to be a bit of an issue for them. The kinetic field is dropped, it's going to be all they need to disengage, but MSS is able to successfully pick up that tower deny. Yaur, getting away with a sliver of his HP, will need to infest into a creep and pop out quickly if he wants to be fighting up on this bottom lane. But meanwhile, top lane, Miracle has finished up those boots of travels and he's farming away, he's flip pushing away, making sure that these lanes are pushed in, and if they do go for this tier 1 tower, it will have to be at the expense of a little bit of ship damage and a lot of pressure being put down towards that top lane, a lot of space being given away towards Miracle, and we all know what Miracle can do with a lot of space, and the answer is quite a lot. And I'm saying a lot quite a bit, but hey, that's not the point. But right now, speaking of quite a lot, Arteezy might need to tone down on those calories since he's getting absolutely fat on this Medusa. And level 11 on him. Highest. Somehow Miracle and Moon Meander actually further ahead, but Moon Meander going in with the roar. Arteezy gets a stone gaze off in time, though. Disruptor ultimate coming through as well. The mana is being drained. Yaur is the one who's going to be turned to stone, and the right click coming through from the Drow Ranger. The damage is insane. Yaur not able to do anything at all, and that's some second most farm hero on the Radiant side. Absolutely no idea what he was doing in that position, and now Miracle taping his way towards that top lane, trying to minimize losses. Trying to make sure that Yaur did not die in vain, but unfortunately the tier 2 tower will not be falling just quite yet. Miracle not too far away from his blink dagger though, and Yaur absolutely no idea what he was doing over there in the back lines behind the tier 1 tower. Not even sure how he got there really. It just seems that Yaur isn't on the same level as the rest of these guys, and I've got to say, MSS as well, seeming a little bit underwhelming. We just haven't seen any of the big flashy Phoenix rotations, any of the big Phoenix plays that we do so often see. Coming out on Phoenix players like Fly, who are just legendary with that hero. And now Arteezy combined with the power of Matumba Man are going to be knocking down on that tier 2 tower, and look at how much damage they deal. That's about 47 more damage going the way of Arteezy, courtesy of that Drow Aura. Matumba Man does not care about Yaur. Glimpse back onto Arteezy. The nice kinetic field being caught, catching out two people. No disruptor ultimate for now, though. It's on cooldown for another 2 seconds. If that was there, that could have been the team fight that they needed. Arteezy is completely out of mana. He won't be able to use the Stone Gaze. Even turning off the mana shield, a clarity even being expended to try and get him up to the point where he can stone gaze himself up. The clarity gonna be cancelled though. The long range shuriken toss just bouncing to and fro in the dire side practically. That's basically the stud of high school is just going into every single person, getting out and getting in again. And so far, I mean, looks like this is a bit of an issue coming up. Miracle though, blinking himself away, does have that blink dagger up and ready. Bulba, same could be said for him. Sunray coming through, MSS will be able to scout that out, but Somel turns around, canceling the blink dagger of Bulba, making sure that the 9k MMR player is able to get away. And we need to remember, this game is it a battle for the ancient, this game is a battle for the kills onto the 9k, and that's really all that matters. But right now, Matumba Man, goddamn close to the 9k mark, but not quite there yet, will be the one going down. That's going to be the Aegis expended Moon Meander. Arteezy for the Stone Gaze being used from very far away, actually. Already out of mana. This is funny, because he uses his Stone Gaze, he's just waddling, and by the time he gets it, because of all the damage coming up from Miracle, because of all the March and all the Rocket Spam and every long-range bit of damage that Miracle is able to provide, Arteezy is out of mana and can't fight him. This is insane. This must be driving him crazy. He's being forced to go for a Lincoln Spear. It's a very defensive build that we normally do frown on, but hopefully it will end up working out. He doesn't need all that much damage because he does have a Drow on his team. Matumba Man going to be helping him out considerably. Dragon Lance and Helm of the Dominator on him as well. Should be stacking Ancients very soon. Bulba smoked up, looking to see what he can get done over here. Top lane, Miracle's the one who's going to be teeping himself out to safety. He's got something in the courier perhaps. Wonder what that could be as Moon. Necro 1 is in his inventory. Yaur going on to MSS. MSS might go down to the neutral creeps over here, courtesy of that open wounds that have been laid out onto him. But Somel, if he throws out, oh god no, Somel, you should have thrown out the shuriken toss onto creeps. If you did that, you would have gotten the kill right there. PPD throws out one last kinetic field before going down. One last attempt to stall Bulba from pursuing up onto his teammates as Echo Saber comes out of the Yaur. Miracle also picking up the energy booster, now going in towards an Aether Lens. Could be a Bloodstone, but somehow I feel like it's not going to be a possibility. Looking over towards the grass, we're looking at about a 300 gold lead for the Radiant side. Absolutely ridiculous. It's completely even gold and experience. Such a nominal difference so far, and this is just a very exciting match to watch. And the Radiant are slowly but surely clawing their way back into this game. But so far, their courses seem a little bit underwhelming. The only way they've been able to keep up so as much as they have is because of the Bounty Hunter and his track kills coming his way. But Somel hasn't gotten a single level up in about 4 to 8 minutes. And this is something that's a big issue. Bounty Hunter really desperately needs that level 11. And now that Life Shield and Fast Bomb coming through. As the pings are coming out that there is a ward in this position, the Tinker Ward has been deployed from the dire side, and now the Lifesteater in Fast Bomb looking to change Somel's underleveled experience as it is. Scouts out the stack, not quite yet, but could have possibly done so if he just went a few more steps further ahead. Arteezy's Lincoln getting procked by the Thunderstrike, making sure that he can glimpse them if need be, but without the vision, they do have a ward in that territory, I suppose, so isn't that much of an issue. But what is an issue is Matumba Man, who's being gone on. Yaur will be able to get that killed. One more right click from Somel was all it needed to ensure that Yaur had a little bit more extra damage, but now it's going to be the turnarounds coming through. Blinken from Bulba is going to be able to get a kill. Disruptor ultimate goes down, but Bulba just simply does not care. Miracle in the Roshan pit, doing whatever he can, throwing out the marches, throwing out the rockets as well, getting a double kill onto both supports. Well, practically two supports, and now it's going to be the true support who's going to be brought back. Crit going to be laser and roared down. It ends up being a 1-for-4. Yaur, the only casualty, and Dire lose quite a few, and where they once seemed underwhelming, Miracle with a positioning advantage with the Aether Lens is able to do so much damage in that team fight. And this is ridiculous as to however well they're doing it. Moon Meander now with a gem purchased stuff for himself. They're trying their best to eliminate all map vision possible. Ortiz is still on the top of the net worth, but that might change very soon. The way that they're playing, the OG, I keep saying OG, but the Radiant side, spearheaded by PPD, should be able to basically completely block out all vision coming out of the Dire side, if with the help of the Beastmaster Hawk as well. The Iron Talon is all that he needs to be able to get these D wards off. He actually chose to go for the Blink Dagger first, and it's fairly obvious why he did that. With the combined mobility of the Blink Dagger on the Beastmaster and the Blink Dagger on the Tinker, they just have such good pickoff potential. You TP the Tinker onto the Hawk, you, which is exactly what they're going for right now. Tinker TPing onto the Hawk, Beastmaster having the ability to blink forward and get the roar out, but unfortunately RTZ has the game sense of a 9km more player, and he's able to get himself away. Crit. 2200 gold on him. Should be, probably is going to be going towards that Blink Dagger. Moon blinking up, making the jungle a little bit, the map a little bit safer for the Tinker. Ooh. It is feeling pretty unsafe TPing in towards the top lane, because he's TPing into four people, but that's a separate story altogether. But, PPD, Aetherlands on him. This is a farm PPD, ladies and gentlemen. This is not something you see every day of the week. And speaking of things we don't see every day of the week, to those of you who are just tuning in, this is the North American Elite League. We've got the most stacked game probably in NEL history going on right now. We've got teams from all over the, players from all over the world. The best players are competing for nothing but pride on the line. And so far, it's been an absolute slugfest from either side. Gower, this player who's been looking slightly underwhelming, still doing so much. Somehow keeping up and farm through the Medusa and the Drow Ranger. He's still a little bit behind, of course, but that's to be expected. He just doesn't have the same farming capabilities on that hero as those range heroes do. Drow Ranger and Medusa just built to farm a lot faster. Crit though gonna be silenced up. That's gonna be a good track kill going their way, while Tinker also getting one onto Slardar. Miracle throws that one last stitch kick. Slardar did go down on the bot lane, and suddenly Matumba Man is gonna be roared up. Tinker can come in onto these, but Tinker might not even be needed. Moon will be able to get this solo kill right now. Matumba Man desperately trying to kill the boar, but now with the Aegis has been expended, Matumba Man needs to try and do whatever he can. He gets the silence up, but not before he will go down to the right clicks of Tinker. Tinker not even needing his spells, and now MSS Icarus Dive still not ready. He's going to be the second casualty. It's going to be a 4 for 0 across the map. Even the Supernova being expended, a few more right clicks is going to be all they need. Will they be able to get him? Yes, they will. Moon picks that up. 4 for 0 across the map. The only survivor being Arteezy in that mid lane, and Arteezy to be careful that he does continue to survive, otherwise this could be an absolute catastrophe. Glimpse back onto Ortiz. He quit being forced to roll himself away as well, and suddenly Miracle with the Aghanim Scepter. This man is looking to be the true 9k, 1 9k to rule them all, 1 9k to find them, 1 9k to bring them all and in the darkness bind them. I'm not casting in a library. My house is, I have a room in my house that we have a lot of books and stuff. So we do still call it the library, to be fair. And it's that's where I cast. Over here right now, Crit blinking forward, getting the kick out, but unfortunately doesn't really do all that much with it. Arteezy slithering away in the Dire side. In the Dire side, whatever you call it. In the Dire side jungle. I forgot for a second, but smoke gank up. Moon could blink in, get the roar onto RTZ. The Lincoln Sphere is propped, and that's the signal for him to get off the stone gate. It's a beautiful timing from RTZ, but it won't matter. Now that he doesn't have any mana, Miracle going on towards the high ground. So much damage being dealt out by the rockets. He's blinking forward, the laser bouncing to and fro. It's just damage being dealt out everywhere so far. Only a 1-for-1 trade, but it should be brought down to a 2-for-1 in favor of the Radiant. Miracle, with the positioning being completely impeccable, no faults possible for there, And now with the Necro Tree probably being flown out very, very soon in about 400 gold for Moon Meander. When he has that up, Arteezy, who's already having so many mana issues, will not be able to do anything at all. Fast fingers or not, that Stone Gaze won't help you if you don't have the mana to fight up afterwards. And Yawr is actually starting to become a little bit of a factor with the potential of Infest Bombs coming through, as he does end up going down to one right click from Matumba Man, perhaps not being in time for the Tread Switch. And really, Yawr just... I've got to say, Yawr is definitely not in the same league as the rest of these players. He just seems to be completely outclassed in this game. And a lot of players back when, back before TI5, they were talking about whether or not Yawr would be picked up over Samel for AG, and that was definitely a possibility. But it's just showing right now that they've got the perfect decisions, and PPD firing shots left, right, and center. Bulma, that's one, that one's gotta hurt after being kicked out from PPD's team. But right now, Miracle is the only one that matters. He's trying to juke away. He's got the haste rune. Can he get away? Can he get to safety? The silence will be wearing off very soon. He has the blink dagger up and ready. He might even go for a turnaround. That's exactly what he does. He refreshes, right click comes through, double kill, gem on the deck. So Mel will be able to pick that up. The urn is dropped, but the silence coming through. Matumba Man might be able to get this kill. Look at how much HP he has. The effective HP is insane, and Matumba Man will end up going down as because of that mechanism being used, just kept him alive for so long. And absolutely ridiculous how well Miracle is playing in this game. Yawr is definitely a tier 2 without a doubt. Like, there's no questions asked about it. I mean, he's definitely a very good player. He's just never, he's just not tier, he's just not tier 1, but right now, Miracle still farming away. He's spent his gold on something. I wonder what it is. It's a soul booster. Now moving in towards the Bloodstorm, where he's able to finish that up. He's going to be having basically infinite mana to be able to deal with, and right now he's not really having too many mana issues either. The spectator chat trying to decide about whose fault it is about the game going one way or the other. By the way, guys, all of you who are following, who are taking the time to click that follow button, thank you very much. I do appreciate it. I'm trying very hard to get to 1,000 followers right now. And right now, Miracle, he's the one. He is the chosen one, really. The Middle East proving to perhaps... Well, technically the Middle West. The Middle West tearing apart the further west. 9,000 MMR may be both their ranking, but so far there's only one clear number one, and that's got to be Miracle, of course. You could put it down to things like, oh, it's a team game, he's got teammates too, Moon Meander's playing like an absolute legend. No, this is Miracle versus Arteezy, and that's all that matters, ladies and gentlemen. As Twitch chat would say, who is left and who is right. The showdown continues, and so far, Arteezy is struggling to keep up. Scotty, this will be helping him out considerably, though. Now that he does have that in his inventory, he will be able to farm up a lot more effectively. He will be able to have a lot more mana to work with, more importantly, while Sumel in that middle lane does end up going down. Yawr is definitely not new to the pro scene. Yawr has been around for as long as Sumel has, like exactly as long as Sumel has, because I remember they were both on some teams together as well. Right now, the Hawk also coming through from the Beastmaster, Moon. Getting closer towards that Vladimir's offering as well. The Necro 3 is already up there for him. Roaming around with a passenger inside of him, Yawr. Probably going to be the only time he ever gets inside of someone else, but... other than his little brother, That was in bad taste. I should probably not have made that joke. But now that Yawr is tired of getting inside of his little brother and ends up getting inside Moon instead. Being said, top lane, it is gonna be Matumba Man. Who's gonna be the one who's under siege? Monster kill from Miracle, and that's exactly what he is. He's an absolute monster. Arteezy TPing himself away. At this point, even Sumail is enough to intimidate out Arteezy. And right now, the Blink Dagger on PPD and Blink Dagger on Drow Ranger, this could be an interesting battle of the Blinks, and I just feel as if the Blink on the Drow Ranger won't be doing that much damage. I mean, that much, that won't be bringing that much to the table. Now, Arteezy getting glimpsed by getting a great Stone Gaze up preemptively, though, and that's gonna allow him to live through this entire ordeal. But now that the Stone Gaze is on cooldown, there is no roar to try and follow up, and Arteezy is not backing off. He's gonna be out of mana very, very shortly. The Mystic Snake helping him out a little bit, but now Yawr getting the open wounds out as well. Bot lane is gonna be the monster kill spree going the way of Stardar. Arteezy's managed to keep the Radiant side busy for long enough to make sure that they aren't able to provide any support towards that Tinker. Moon was not able to TP in and try to make sure that Miracle was able to live. So well played by Arteezy, and that good coordination coming out from the Dire across the board. Bulba as well. 3,000 gold on him after getting that kill. He's going to be more than happy with that. Probably going to be going in towards something like a, I guess a Lotus Orb wouldn't be too bad. But it's not really something that you want to be going for. An Assault Crisis is an option, but it's very expensive and you most likely want to be saving for buyback. So with buyback, that's about, give or take another 3,500 gold. That's not really something you can reasonably expect to farm up unless you magically get another few streaks like you did before, as Crit just throwing down, popping down a ward onto the high ground. Miracle being given the assistance from the boar, and he does have a Dagon to his inventory, Dagon in his inventory. And I really like this fake from Tinker players at a high level. So they keep a bottle, they don't sell it, they just keep it in their stash, and they're able to just continually they just switch it out continually with a Dagon too. And when they're at base, when they're at fountain, they minimize the time that they're actually spending within the fountain by switching it out and using the bottle charges on themselves and on their allies too sometimes, which is a really interesting little play. It doesn't seem like much, but all these little things do count up. He probably saves like a minute or two per game that he plays a Tinker doing tricks like that. And a minute or two is a large percentage of a game that comes down to, even in a long game, 50 minutes is a long game by any stretch, and 2 minutes is what, 4% of that game. That's 4% of that game that he spends more time doing things. And that just goes to show these are the little things that make a massive difference. And now Matumba Man, he's the little thing that could make a massive difference if he goes down as well. Blink forward from Bulba, but it's the Slardar Crush is dodged completely from Tinker. And Tinker's gonna be able to get himself away scot-free. Dakin 2 on him as well now. And Arteezy is going in for a rapier, possibly. Could be, I suppose it could be an MKB to try and deal with the laser, but I would personally like to see a rapier for obvious reasons. I do need to quickly check out whether or not something is taking a lot of CPU usage. Well, that being said, we see a roll forward, the Sunray being used preemptively as well. My FPS is dropping, which is why I was just checking. I think I need to restart Dota after this. If there will be another person coming in, well, if there's gonna be another game after this that's as good as this, then I'm definitely gonna be casting that. In the meanwhile though, Miracle, Dagon 3. That Dagon 3 just looks so impressive in that inventory. It just looks like you look at that and you immediately just expect to be going down over here. Crit did expect to be going down. That's why he ends up being forced to fog. But Bulba force-stopping himself forward, blinking himself forward. Arteezy trying his damned hardest to go in with the Stone Gaze, just not able to close the distance. Suicide comes through from the Tinker. And the Phoenix Egg does end up popping. It will be able to get a stun onto two people. The gem has hit the deck, so Mel is doing whatever he can to try and get a kill here and there. The Slaughter does end up going down. The Greaves being used by the Bounty Hunter, but to bottom lane is where the action is at. Yowr's just tearing apart on this tier 3, but this guy has no damage. Yowr just doesn't do anything. He needs to be fighting with his team. If he was over there, that could have been a different fight altogether. The biggest... biggest thing over there was that Yowr with the rage can easily tear apart the Phoenix Egg. When that happens, the Phoenix Egg doesn't go off. They don't have to be afraid. They don't have to be getting away that they are. Yowr is completely useless. That's all he needs to do in these team fights to be able to win them. There is no BKBs on the Dire side. Miracle can do everything, and that's exactly what he's doing right now. He's going to be trying to make sure that they're not able to go into Roche Pit. And now look at this. Yowr doesn't do anything. This is what I'm talking about. He's raging and he's keeping away. That's the limit. That's all he provides. At this point, he's a walking, talking Phoenix Egg Disabler. He's the fetus popper. That's what he is. And Crit, he's the one who's going to end up going down over here in exchange for the Roshan going the way of the Dire side. Aegis of the Immortal going to be going on to... I don't even know, and Aegis goes on to Ranger. I'm getting very frustrated by Yowr's play in this game. Aoi does in fact tend to play naked during the boot camp. I know. It's very interesting. I'm sorry I'm bashing on Yowr that much, but let's be real. Yowr is being completely outclassed. Even MSS, who's supposed to be a worse player than Yowr, is playing very, very well in this game, considering that he is playing a support role, which he doesn't normally play, I believe. And, okay, he has an Assault Crest now, so I guess he can bash up on buildings a little bit more. He does provide them a little bit more armor against the Medusa's, but... the spit shot and everything, which is all fine and dandy and it's useful, but you need to be in the team fight for that to happen. And if next time Yowr isn't in that team fight, if they end up losing that team fight again, that's just completely on him. Yes, the top lane team fight would have still probably gone the way of the Dire's. MSS plays mid, seriously? Well, anyway, so. But in Yowr's defense, obviously the top lane was a great initiation from Bulba and everything that I didn't think he would be able to get that. And oh my goodness, speaking of great initiation from Bulba, that's a two-man's crush. And I think I've got a one-man crush onto Bulba if he keeps playing like this. Like, he's really stepping his game up. And... he's taking it to the next level right now. So Mel, Guardian Greaves on him. Magic one as well. Doing very well for himself. So guys, to those of you who are asking about my streaming schedule, I'm going to be streaming every night. For me, it's night. So whatever time it is at your place, minus 6 hours, that's when I'm going to start streaming every night. North American Elite League starts around that time, so I'm going to be streaming from there onwards. I'm just going to be doing Nell, and I might be doing maybe a little bit of other games throughout the day. Basically, I'm trying to get my hands on everything I can cast right now. All I have access to is Nell. So if you guys have any contacts in BTS or in Moondock, you know, hook a brother up. But RTZ in the meanwhile... 3,500 gold on him. I'm interested to see what he goes for next. That MKB doing serious work. Giving him the ability to be able to right-click away through the anchor laser. Definitely completely necessary. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Thank you for the feedback, Janice. In my defense, it's kind of 6 a.m. where I am, and I am basically completely dead. And speaking of completely dead, Arteezy over here might be completely dead as well. He has the gem, the gem will hit the deck, it will go the way of Samel most likely. He should be able to drop down his magic wand for that if he so chooses to do so. And now blinking forward is going to be the Miracle Tinker, who's able to get a quick kill onto MSS. It's a quick 1-2, MSS without the buyback. Medusa fortunate enough to possess the buyback, of course, but unfortunately that might not very well be enough. We've seen how instrumental MSS's eggs and his third ability. What's his third ability? Right, Sunray. Dude, I don't know. My head is actually like, my head is hurting. You should check the FAQ what my favorite tea is. So you actually understand what happens over there. Isn't the FAQ, but now Miracle, he's the one who's been silenced off somehow by some miracle. They actually managed to get a kill onto the Tinker. I didn't think they would be able to do that over there. Miracle without buyback, maybe this is a bit of an opening for them. Roshan does have quite a bit of time before it does respawn though. So Arteezy with 2400 gold on him may as well just choose to buy out at this point, whatever he wants to be going for next. Will be a butterfly, which I think is a good choice. It's an interesting choice. I'm not going to say it's a good choice. I would have personally preferred a satanic. It helps him tank up quite a bit. He's not really having any issues getting the right clicks out. He's not being kited or anything. Maybe even start building in towards a moon shard, because right now the only right click damage is coming in from the life shooter, and life shooter is basically a non-factor so far. I've harped on about that enough, but I would have liked to see a satanic. But speaking of satanics, there is one coming out onto Matumba Mine, so that's a good pickup over here. So Mel should be able to get a kill onto the crit over here. But okay, blink in stun from Bulba. He's trying to make sure that they aren't able, that he isn't able to pick up the kill onto crit, and crit, it's a perfect bait and the good sentry ward placement for MSS. Heads up play from him, realizing that Sumail might be in pursuit. Well, not everyone in Pakistan is related, I can promise you this. I'm related to 189 million people of the 190 million population that we have, but that population of the world might be going down just now as Arteezy should be taking a fall, and without buyback, this could very well be game. It's all up to Matumba Man and the squad to somehow try and get this kill, and now with the Aegis being reclaimed as well, this is going to be even harder, being forced to back himself off after getting the significant slow out onto Disruptor. Disruptor though somehow very, very tanky, sitting at 1200 HP, and the armor coming out from the... Oh, wait, hold that thought. No, the armor coming out from the Assault Cries of the Lifesteer definitely was helping him a lot. Now, over here, we do see Lifesteer just tearing into the creep wave. Matumba Man's taking a lot of damage from both the Tinker. Tinker actually blinking himself forwards, gets the immediate kill onto Matumba Man. Bulba BKB is up, trying to do whatever he can. Crit as well, just trying to stall for time. Does have the rolling boulder. He will be forced to use it. Gets away for now, but the glimpse back and Miracle blinking forward. It's a triple kill for him. He's just absolutely taking full control of this game. And GG has called the war between Arteezy and Miracle is over, ladies and gentlemen. Team Miracle take the game in a very convincing fashion after it being very back and forth early on. It did end up... my hand hurts. Well, it did end up being Miracle who